has a very good ear for city girls.
Pippen. Now Pip left of the key against Russell. A step back three for the lead. Yes!
Yes!
7.3 remaining, and Utah calls time. Oh, Scottie Pippen, we love you!
As a team, that's the way we've approached this whole season, is that we're going to all do this together. And, you know, we're not labeled as a team with one great superstar. I mean, we just got a lot of guys to come out and play hard.
The 1999-2000 Portland Trail Blazers were a team in the truest sense of the word, and hard work was its calling card. The Blazers tied the second best record in franchise history with 59 regular season victories and advanced to the Western Conference Finals for the second straight year.
Throughout, we had a ups and downs season for us, our standards, but if you look at it, winning 59 games, could have won 60. And getting to the seventh game of the conference finals and also had a chance to win that, I think the season was great.
The summer of 99 saw the arrival of Pippen, Smith, and Detlef Schrempf, proven NBA professionals brought in to help Portland take another step toward a title. The talents were obvious, but many feared there was too much talent on this squad and that egos would clash. It couldn't have been farther from the truth, as sacrifice for the good of the team was a common theme.
What you hear, you start believing, and then you start listening to, but I never really believed in it. People started saying we weren't going to have enough basketballs. It wasn't going to be enough time. But I think our team, and as individuals and as a whole team, we pretty much deleted all those rumors. Guys played together. No guy worried about the individual stats, and it was just about wins. And we pretty much did that all year.
And what a year it was. The Blazers shot out of the gate to a 13-3 record and set the tone for the season. Portland, with coach's selection to the All-Star team Rasheed Wallace, led the league in field goal percentage and finished third in defense. That usually added up to a victory. Soon expectations were soaring higher and higher. Chapman had it knocked away. Pippen, Anthony to Scottie by himself to dunk it. Oh yeah!
Set up high, I'm strong enough to take these dreams and make them mine.
Shot away and put the pressure on the official. Wallace looks at the clock.
Got it with 1.3.
The road was a friend to the turn of the century Trailblazers. Portland finished the regular season with a franchise best 29-12 road record. And when at home, you could count on some of the most raucous fans in the league. The Rose Garden was sold out for the entire season and boasts an active 58-game sellout streak. Blazer fans are a passionate lot, and the team gave them plenty to celebrate.
For me to have almost 10,000 at an Interscott scrimmage, to have probably 10,000 to 15,000 people before the tip-off every night, and to have 20,000 every night, I mean, it was an unbelievable experience for me, and I really enjoyed it.
Portland enjoyed being in the NBA playoffs for an amazing 18 straight season. The team's first opponent, Kevin Garnett, and the Minnesota Timberwolves. The T-Wolves battled hard, but couldn't stay with the talented Blazers and fell in four games.
Clock's at five. Scottie, Rasheed's open. Yeah! Oh, baby, what a big shot, Rasheed Wallace!
The Blazers' playoff excitement was interrupted shortly thereafter. Popular assistant coach Bill Musselman lost his battle with cancer and passed away due to complications of the disease.
The Blazers mourn his loss, but are thankful for the time we had with Coach Musselman. He was a valued member of the Blazers organization and the Portland community. At this time, we ask that you observe a moment of silence in memory of Muss, Coach Bill Musselman.
The loss of Muss was a blow to the entire organization, but the team rallied and showed its mettle against the Utah Jazz.
Pip throws to Wallace, 20-footer out of the key, long. Sabonis grabs the rebound. Sabonis to a Connie Wallace for the dunk. Oh,
For the second consecutive season, Portland and the veteran Jazz locked up in the conference semifinals. And for the second straight year, the Blazers advanced. Up next was the rival Los Angeles Lakers in the Western Conference Finals. The two best teams in the league battled for the full seven games in what most thought was the real NBA Finals.
Bonzi maneuvers against Fox to Smitty. Smitty, a three-pointer left side. Yeah!
Woo-hoo! Both teams battled all season for the home court advantage, only to see the visiting teams win four times during the memorable series. League MVP Shaquille O'Neal put up solid numbers, but didn't dominate as Scottie Pippen and the Blazers battled tooth and nail. Despite controlling many of the games for most of the contest, Portland fell behind 3-1 in the series, but quitting was never considered, and the team regrouped to force a seventh and deciding game in the Staples Center.
The thing I liked about this team and the fans here, no one gave up, and all the way to the end.
The end came in Los Angeles when the eventual champion Lakers rallied to win Game 7. Portlanders were disappointed, but reveled in what was certainly one of the most successful seasons in the franchise's 30 years.
It was a very good year.
The best is coming next year. Not yet to come, it's coming.
Still, it's a real good bet. The best is yet to come.